Nothing compares to a burger. Nothing. Absolutely nothing compares to a deliciously succulent burger dripping in sauce and filled with flavorful toppings and, of course, a great patty. And if a plant-based meal is what you're after, this Be Well Sweet Beets and Bean Burger is gonna hit the spot. Plus, it's packed with anti-inflammatory ingredients, making it nutritious and delicious. Maxwell Janssen from Bootleg Burgers is here to tempt me this morning. Maxwell, buddy, you put us through pain. Every burger that you made for Zoe when you guys were out on location, it was torture for us sitting in here just watching.
Graham, your face was magic, my man. It said it all.
You hit me in the feels, man. You cut me deep. You cut me real deep, Shrek. So I'm really excited about this one. And I love the fact because you make some legendary burgers.
Thank you
we
very
know
much,
this,
man.
Which is why we hunted you out.
Yeah, baby.
And you really pushed the boat out in terms of the ingredients that you put into your patties. And this one, I'm looking at a beautifully formed patty there. Sweet beets and beans. This is veg, which is great. So many people are making that shift now, as many of us should do at the moment, to just be a bit more conscientious about how we eat. So I suppose we should dive right in. What
Absolutely.
Goes into making of the patty?
Look, healthy should never be boring, right?
100%,
healthy
yeah.
should bring that flavor. So for the patty concoction we're making, it is grated beets. We've got our black beans. You can either have it cooked or straight out of the can. Onions. Let me mix it up while I'm at it.
You're doing that.
Right, so that diced onion, please be aware that this recipe really works better in a food processor, because you've got to get that work through, right?
So you want everything to be as finely
absolutely,
chopped and well mixed as possible.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So, red beets, chopped onion, we've got the red chili flakes, some salt, garlic, let's get that bad boy out in there.
Wow.
Right, cumin.
So you're not holding back on
flavor,
hey?
Flavor, man, flavor. Of course, look, all plants has got this natural sweetness and all that magic that happens, but we're just trying to enhance it,
you
right?
You gotta activate those flavors.
That is
sure,
correct.
Okay.
So give that a little mix through. Get that flavors in. Now, we have got dry thyme. We have got dried parsley to get that, again, the anti-inflammatory flavors, real flavor and effectiveness, right?
Yeah.
All those in there.
I suppose that's something that we often forget about in the plant-based diet. What you're able to do is really get the nutrients.
Absolutely.
It's the reason why we identify with all these colors as being
that's
healthy.
Correct.
Is because they contain the vitamins and, as you said, the anti-inflammatory properties.
Absolutely, absolutely. Once you get the wet nice and through, right, we add our black beans, and that will give it that nice and chunkiness. Right. Oh, it smells delicious already. Just have a little whiff there.
Oh,
magic. Right. Now, of course, canola seeds, walnuts, all process-based. Not too finely, though. But again, you want that texture to come through.
Sure. Okay, so that's a textural element, and it's also going to help to bind, I would imagine, like a breadcrumb would, for instance, in a
exactly.
normal
patty.
Exactly.
Okay. That does help a little bit with the binding, but here lays the magic of the binding. Right. So, that is our chickpea flour. Just drizzle all that bad boy on top there. Yep.
You've been doing this, eh? You didn't just fall off the back of a food truck and throw this recipe out there.
Man, have you ever seen what people's faces look like when they just get good grub in front of them?
Yeah.
Right,
I remember Zoe's face quite clearly. I remember crying. I don't think we cooked a thing in studio that day. So we literally, the kitchen was bare, bro. The kitchen was bare.
And never looked so clean.
And Zoe had, what, 5 burgers that day, I think?
Okay, it was 3, to be fair, it was 3. Right, so just on the other side of the pan, I've got this pan just warming up on this side. Right, when all of this is mixed nice and through, right, now the trick is to let it rest, right?
Okay.
Let it rest in the fridge a little bit to just pull together. Form your patties on cling wrap, whatever the case may be. Then again, let it rest overnight. Now for the magic of TV.
Ta-da!
We've already had a patty rested, properly made. Again, just a little bit of flour.
Yeah.
The colour, look. Veggie patties is always troublesome because, you know, it doesn't really depict the burger.
Doesn't look the part,
but the
yeah.
blue, the beet and the beets and of course, the black beans just does
Nails
that
it.
Magic, yeah?
Dude, I've got to ask you, as you put this puppy into the frying oil there, our theme today is all about childhood games. And we're not talking about Fortnite. We're talking about, like, physical games that you had to play, like marbles. Did you have any games that you played when you were a kid?
Look, there's games we grew up with that should never be mentioned on TV, first and foremost. Look, where you come from, where I come from.
I was going to say that. What did you do? Like, did you throw rocks? We made bows and arrows. I remember at boarding school, things kind of got Lord of the Flies-y very quickly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, and generally with boys, it would go towards some kind of craziness where someone would get hurt. And most games, someone inevitably got hurt.
Yeah.
But we'd come up with crazy games. Like, we had this one where we would go around the entire school without touching the ground.
Pretty much.
You would, like, you'd climb from this thing to this thing to this thing. And then inevitably someone would break an arm, and then it was, like, the end of the game.
Okay. And it was, look, who can handle the thing the most?
Give me something
but
to do
here.
I've got my B-Well here ready to rock and roll. It's dairy-free, incidentally, which is something that's really worth noting. And, of course, got all the right kind of fats endorsed by the Heart and Stroke Foundation of South Africa, which doesn't come lightly. What am I doing?
It's very important to also note that this dish is packed with omega-3s.
Mm.
Like all that good oils
the
and all
right
that
kind
magic.
Of oils.
So what you
want
to do, you want to put 2 spoons of the B-Well in
and
there.
What have we gone for? We've gone for the thick and creamy, baby, of
course.
Yeah,
man. So 3 to 2 spoons of that.
Sure.
Tomato. Any tomato sauce, guys. Your favorite tomato sauce, add that, right?
You can get nice organically sourced.
That's it. And, of course, just some sriracha. Just to bring that, just a little bit of heat through, and that will make the base of that amazing
burger
sauce.
I think sriracha's kind of got a sweet heat to it, so I think that'll complement the sweetness of the burger.
Because of that smoked paprika and sriracha, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, you want to put the dollop on there.
On the
bun.
I see you've grilled your bun. Is that the way to go with the burger?
Yes, toasted bun always. Nothing hurts more than a soggy bun, right? So you want to toast the bun so that all the juices sits on top of it, not draws into it immediately, right?
Okay, you've got 10 seconds to put this
awesome
burger together. How's
so
it going to look?
So that just there, do a little cucumber, a little rocket, and of course the patty on top, and of course for the magic of TV, right
dun,
on
dun,
the
dun,
side,
dun.
Graham. That amazing finished product, sir.
I'm going to have a bite just to follow in Zoe's footsteps.
Absolutely. Again, the rocket, the pepper, the pepperness, the cucumber, the avo, lots of avo on top. Yes!
Mm.
Look at that center of that bad boy.
Do I sauce all over my face?
No, you don't. You should go in for another bite then in that case.
Dude, are you kidding me, bro?
How's that for a vegetarian B-Well burger?
That is absolutely beautiful. If you missed any of the steps, take a look at this. This is super. Wow, dude.